kind of hurt because, like, you know, we all just kind of expected we were going to win it all. Like, we didn't even really think it was, like, a possibility we were going to lose. So, like, I guess we were sleeping and they caught us.
You know, that one loss last season, I think, honestly benefited us into having the great season that we did. And then just losing to Mary's, all when it mattered, you know, it was just a tough loss. And there wasn't much to say after that because it was all the seniors' last game. So, like, maybe our success just got in the way. You know, we thought that we had a easy path and kind of let off the gas a bit, and it ended up catching up to us, you know. I think we'll have a good run. You know, we took some losses early on, which I think will benefit us. So I think that we'll have a good postseason. It's a really big season, you know. Because the past few years we've been close to winning stuff, but we haven't gotten to the end goal that we've wanted to and what we've talked about. So it's our last chance to go and get a state championship.
Mean to you?
It means a lot. Kind of shaped me into the person I am today. It's helped me in a lot of ways.
What has basketball done for you?
Taught me how to be a man. Went through a lot as a kid, and it's kind of just been like a safe haven for me to do whatever I want.
And what will you always remember about playing basketball at Brother Rice?
The home games. Those are the things I used to look forward to. So I hate that it's coming to an end, but I wouldn't change a thing about it.
It done a lot for me. It really showed me to surround myself with people that has the same goals as me and work as hard as them. And the senior showed me that I have to work hard no matter like the circumstance, no matter the game. And I have to install that into the underclassmen and make them work hard, make them play hard every game, no matter who we play.
All right, so back in eighth grade and a little bit of freshman year, I was trying to find a way to make money, so I started reselling shoes, and so my Instagram name was Cash Money Kicks.
Did you sing this your theme song?
No, I could not. I could not.
Hey, guys.
So, Elijah, when you ought to be get running, Chase, when you get running, Luke, Jeremiah, we have to find 22 on every one. And the reason why we spend a lot of time here is they run four out. So they're dribble drive a lot. So when they go to score, they don't have a lot of people around the rim. It's only him.
Welcome to Brother Rice High School for this interscholastic contest between the Warriors of Woodhaven and the Warriors of Brother Rice. Both Woodhaven and Brother Rice strive towards good sportsmanship and a spirit of healthy competition.
Boom! He's got a triple! He's got a double! feel about today? How do you feel about today?
I think I played pretty well. Team got a 40-point win, so you know, feeling pretty good and ready to get to the next one.
Yep. That's great to hear. That's great to hear, Luke. How do you feel about this team? The energy the team just gives off. How do you feel?
Man, it's awesome. You know, we all run. We all pass to each other. Everyone's dunking. Everyone's finishing. And, you know, especially when we get the crowd into it, it feels great.
You feel like the team gets along pretty well in practices and games?
Yeah, no, we're for real brothers. You know, we do a lot of stuff together, and we just love being around each other. Appreciate it.
I think the student section factors in tremendously. When you talk about coming into our gym, which is a small barn, you know, with limited seating, and when our students show up, it is a huge advantage for our team. This is a difficult place to play in. I know our gym has been known as a shooter-friendly gym, but when we have a student section that's appropriate, rowdy, ruckus, I think our guys and our coaching staff feeds off that energy, and I know that Coach Palmer appreciates you guys.
Our students are unbelievable. I know it means a lot to me when they're there. I know what it means to our guys.
Guys, what are you doing here at the game tonight?
Brian Sports.
All right, what are you guys doing over in the stands?
Everybody's locked in and Jeremiah's dancing or doing something.
Music is always my energy. That's where I get my energy from, or like, that's what gets me pumped up and get my adrenaline going. So like you said.
U of D, you know, again, they probably wish they were us. So, you know, again, we beat U of D in pretty much everything.
Take a deep breath. And Lord, thank you for this day. Your word says this is the day that you have made. Let's rejoice and be glad in it. We rejoice in this atmosphere. We rejoice in this opportunity, this moment. Now let us come with our full hearts, with a focus, with an intensity, with a passion. We play in a way to glorify you. Let's play for each other. And let's play until it says zero on the clock, but with us with more points than the coach. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Last thing on rebounds. Free throw rebounds are big. We're not giving up a free throw rebound there. We're not giving up a free throw rebound. Here we go. Let's go after it, all day. Rice on me, rice on three. 1, 2, 3. Rice!
Thank you.
run offense, rebounds, three. Okay, we got some guys in here kind of tiptoeing. No, this is a Catholic League game. Get the ball, be tough, be physical. They're not calling a foul. Stop looking for it. Be tough. Get open. Handle it and finish. We got the ball right around the rim, and we're waiting for the refs to bail us out. They're not calling a foul. How many times we foul them? They're not calling it. They're not going to call a push. They're not going to call a hold. Get the ball. Okay? That's all it is right now. We're playing great defensively. We're slowing them down in transition. They can't score in the half court on us. Okay? The couple times they score, we just didn't get matched up.
And loose balls off the
rebounds. And it's loose balls off the rebounds. Okay? Absolutely not. All right, we got you out there with just two. Now it's time to go. Rice on me, rice on three. One, two, three. We play our best game. Absolutely not.
And timeouts.
To play our best game? Absolutely not. Okay? And what I'm the proudest of is, like, I don't see anybody holding their head. So, let's go.
My name is Jeremiah Caffey. I graduate 2025. I'm a junior, and I play small forward. Originally, I'm from Pontiac, Michigan. I was located in Florida, so I went to Bell Creek Academy. We had a situation to why we came back to Michigan, so it was like we applied to a whole bunch of different schools, and Rice, well, I didn't have an opportunity to come here, so I'm in Royal Oak right now. I started my sophomore year, so like my the beginning of my sophomore year is when I started. Like, I learned how to be a team player. I learned how to build chemistry with my teammates and actually see them how they are as a person rather than just basketball. I just feel like we had more of a inside connection rather than just a basketball connection. And I was able to, like, communicate with them and connect with them on a different level. The times we've been out, like, I think we went out a couple times, like, say we went to Cookie Boys, something like that. I just feel like it's those moments that you're gonna remember, and that's how you connect when you just around each other. This season, it means a lot. I feel like it's, especially in my being my junior year, this is like a growth point to where you should maximize your potential at this point. And I just feel like it's going to be a special year for us to connect with, especially with the younger guys that we have.
Yeah.
And it's just a time to basically have fun and get down to business and just figure out how to get the job done.
This group of guys' chemistry, as far as their relationships with the coaching staff, with each other, I think was something that I appreciated. So that was a microcosm of our brotherhood being displayed on the court throughout the course of the year.
My world of coaches, we all kind of, there's guys you get along with and are friends with, and so you always check on each other when things are going bad, and I just kept saying it's a great group.
Why you guys got look like goons? Let's go have some fun. When's the last time you like, not ever, except when you score. You want to score, then you want to clap. Yeah, let's get us going. We smacked the floor in practice a couple times at work. When's the last time we do that against EC? The game is supposed to be the bumper. All right, let's be into it. Let's have energy, all the best Mudita, everything that we want to be about, let's go show. All right, and it's a good opponent, not a big X and O game. Yeah. We'll make plays, let's have some fun. Let's go get it done. All right, somebody right on 30, 1-3.
Right. I get a hint of
it. He hasn't played in either of their losses. He didn't play in one of their losses.
And let me tell you,
so don't look at their record. They're
2-0. They're 2-0, and they're murdering everybody they come in contact with. Last night they won by 50. You're in a good position to guard him. Okay, you're a little bit bigger than he is, but he's pretty athletic. All right, number two, Daryl Tompkins. Okay, he's only averaging 3 points a game. Good shooter, really athletic. Okay, quick. You gotta push him left and kind of expect him to go back to his right. Okay, you have to protect the ball around any of these guys, him specifically. Okay.
Rick Palmer, I'm the head basketball coach at Brother Rice. Grew up right around the corner. I was went to Country Day my whole life, and then played at Albion College for 4 years. Was a 2-year captain there, 4-year letterman. After that, went to coach 2 years of college basketball. Won at Lakeland College in Sheboygan, Wisconsin, as a graduate assistant, and then went to got an opportunity to go to the Division I level at Bowling Green in Ohio. And then after that, just kind of decided like doing it for a living wasn't really what I wanted to do. So I came back, moved back here, went to work for my family business, and started coaching at the high school and AAU level. So did 5 years assistant coach at Country Day, which is an amazing opportunity. Got to coach with the guy I played for, Coach Keener, long time legendary coach, was there his last 5 years. And then also coached for the family AAU program, the organization that I played for. So being able to come back and kind of cut my teeth coaching with Coach Walker, who runs the family, and Coach Keener, guys who I played for and then got to learn from as a coach, was outstanding. And then this was my sixth year at Brother Rice.
I got it's a great coach. Puts us in good places to succeed.
I think he's a good coach, you know. He puts together a good scout and watches a lot of film for us, so.
Or crash. Either get back if it's your time to get back, or crash. Sitting there and doing neither is not an option. Jeff, if you do neither, your name's going to get called. You're going to have consequences of the press. Any questions on that? Evan, let's go.
Five, Sean, Spirit. Dear God, please let us have a good practice. Everyone stay focused, healthy, no injuries, and get ready to beat St. Mary's. Our Father.
Lord in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
1, 2, 3.
Guys, go.
So what's up, Matt?
Megan
and I working. Someone here.
Rice.
But I think we can take advantage of him. He's going to be a size mismatch, and that's only going to close the line with him together. So let's be aware of him. He's really good in transition, all right? So, like, when they run off the steal, he's looking
to do the right stuff, okay? Wall up. Don't try to block shots. Wall up. And then if you're big and you're in the paint, you get one dribble maybe, okay? You put the ball on the court more than twice, and it's gone for you, okay?
So, how about this down here? Let's be desperate. Let's be desperate to play well. Forget the best for one. Let's be desperate to go out here in the first position. Not desperate to let's score one more point than them and win at the end. No. Desperate the entire game. Every possession, every game, everything we do. Everything matters. Every little detail. Let's be desperate to win every single little inch of this game. Okay? We gotta say much more than that, man. I don't know if we can do an opportunity. Let's go.
Elite warm-up.
Hey, and now listen to me. When we go out here and we're desperate for every inch and we win this game, we ain't running, no one's rushing the court. We play our best. Let's see, I don't think our best loses tonight. Here we go.
Where's somebody rice up there? 1, 2, 3.
Rice. Right. Here we go.
Somebody
listening. You ready?
We're
Come on, let's go. BTA.
BTA, man.
There we go.
Bro, what kind of question is that? Come on, man.
Hey, Rory, we have 50 coming in.
What?
We
you have 50.
50?
It's great families and great people. When you look at, you look at a De La Salle and you see the lineage of, dads that send their kids there and the kids grow up and then they coach there. And it's similar to, again, our story here at Brother Rice or even CC, where, you're getting all these people that they play, they compete, they leave, and then they come back. And that makes a big difference in terms of the history and the value and how much the kids want it. When you're invested with your family, and it goes deeper than just 4 years, it's a lifelong connection to the school. And when you feel that connection, it's just different.
Off the bounce, and this is going to be true with all four guards, you want to make them take like contested minutes.
Number two, Elijah Wells!
set the away screen for one. Okay? I mean, going on the court. Division one senior, right? We gotta go, gotta have it. Ready to nut up, play through it, and go. Okay? You guys are really gonna be disappointed to hear this, but none of us are gonna see any of us tomorrow. Okay?
What?
We got a day off tomorrow.
Oh, yeah. No way! Oh, man. Man. I don't even see you guys!
Hey, I want to say, we got punched the last three games as a points, and we didn't answer the bell. We got punched early in our own house, 8-0, and then responded by only letting them score 7 points in freaking 13 minutes. And in the fourth quarter, where mentally you were the tougher basketball team, even though the shots didn't go, I loved it. Nobody put their head down. We didn't turn the ball over one time in that last 3 or 4 minutes in the backcourt. Dave took care of the ball. Our guards took care of the ball. Hey, now you understand why we do lines in the cage? Now you understand why we do the disadvantage drills? We're going to handle those moments. Trevor, huge minutes. Luke playing with 4 fouls. Jeremiah giving us 5 minutes. Like, overall, guys, that is a gritty effort. And if you're going to win the championship, we're going to have to win some ugly games. That's just how it is. And so that was to me the one of our most greediest wins of this whole season. And with our backs up against the wall, you could have been seeing ghosts for the last 4 games. But you didn't. You just dialed in to what needed to be done. So super, super proud of what we do.
Who you not letting date your daughter?
Rory Cabana.
Who not letting date your daughter?
Dave.
Okay. A1, is it good? A1, is it good?
All right, bro,
is it good?
Is it good?
Hey, wait, 1 out of 10, how good is that?
8.
Okay.
I've eaten it. That's good.
If you can't break bread.
Can you break bread? Because some people is hungry.
Hey,
we're hungry.
Hey, you tried to do a mukbang, bro.
Hey, Jeremiah.
You got going?
Hey. We're hungry.
Having grown up in the rivalry with my dad coaching football and baseball as long as he did, having all my brothers come through here, there was nothing like playing CC. And getting ready to compete against a group of people who were like-minded, you knew that they were going to come prepared. You knew that they were going to play as hard as they could. There was just no question that every time you played, it was going to be a battle. And I always admire the fact that they believe in what they do just as strongly as we believe in what we do. And so you combine talent with people who believe, and all of a sudden you're like, you never know what's going to happen. So I have the ultimate respect for CC, even though I always want to beat them the worst. I remember my freshman year in football, they were driving down the field at the end of the game. We were up three, and they threw a long pass down the sideline, and I was a free safety, and I jumped in and intercepted it, and we secured the win. We won our junior year in the boys' bowl against CC. Those were two great memories. Come from behind victory.
Doors of the gymnasium. As we welcome our 1974 Brother Rice varsity basketball team, who this week celebrates 50 years since winning the 1974 Michigan High School Basketball State Championship. It was the first state championship in the school's history, and the catalyst for the 80 state titles that we now hold today, which is the most in the state of Michigan.
Everyone's good, and you know, we're all trying to do the same thing. We're bringing in great kids, giving them a good education. You're getting great coaches to try to train them up, high expectation levels, and ultimately you get a lot of kids that are competitive. And so you know, it's us versus them, and everyone wants to establish that they're the best. And so when you lose, you figure out a way to try to win and not let that happen anymore. And it doesn't surprise me that, you know, again, the Catholic League gets after each other.
Coach, we're starting at the scout, we just got to finish up here, so I got this. All right? TJ and AJ, you guys should know this stuff now, second time we've played them. All right? Shooter first, driver second. We are limiting help with him. Elijah, you're going to start on him. All right? But guys, if we're switching ball screens, Trev, Luke, when you switch on him, eliminate the three. Okay, no threes for 22. Stay down. You know he loves the pump fake. You know he loves the pump fake. And then when he's driving, all right.
We need it. We got to take joy, immense joy, tonight in spinning for the open three versus forcing something up. We got to take immense joy in getting the offensive rebound and pass it to somebody else. We got to take immense joy in taking the charge tonight when your chin goes to the basket. It's all about our culture. And so I end with this. I read this, and everybody's saying multiple efforts.
Multiple
efforts. Coach talked about this. It takes a lot of work to close out on the three and then not get open swing at your line drive. But that's what we need tonight. So this scripture is Proverbs 24 and 23. It says, a little extra sleep, a little more slumber, and a little folding the hands to rest, and then poverty pounces on you like a bandit, and scarcity attacks you like a robber. The moment you relax is the moment you are ultimately screwed. The moment we say, you know what, I can take a breath, is the moment when ultimately they get an offensive remodel wide open three. Do not rest tonight. We rest on the bench, and we rest when we're done with the game.
Number four.
the forward. At 6 foot, number 22.
On the flow, yeah, go, go, go. This a battlefield, you know how it goes. Losing side, winning side, pick a side, run or die, go on live and live it up. Warriors attack, no one going back, boy, on the gas, take a fight, go on and live it up. Going for the win, every team we don't spin, we don't take it on the chance, this way it begins.
Different sports that are being played, and you can see it at all levels, whether it's lacrosse or baseball, football, basketball. You're seeing all this this talent, and it's being, like I said, it's being coached by people who have high expectations. Their standards are are set, and the kids have to meet those standards on a daily basis, and there's just no wiggle room. Everybody's got to compete. Everyone's got to show up every day, and all of a sudden you combine high expectations with great coaching, and you have tremendous talent, and then you have an unstoppable league.
Yeah, I got to go to the dinner Thursday night they had, where 9 of the 12 players were there, all three assistant coaches. Coach Norton was there. It was a pretty powerful night. You know, 9 of the 12, there, two of them, unfortunately, are deceased. So only one guy was missing. He had major back surgery the month before. So basically the whole team that was still alive and could be here, anyone who physically could be there was there, including assistant coaches and Coach Norton. And when he stood up and spoke, it was pretty powerful. So I know for me, having them in our locker room before the game, the pep rally, everything was just really, really first class and really cool to see.
They rushed the court. They didn't shake hands with us.
They just talked trash the whole way.
Talked trash.
Newspaper talked trash.
We said, yeah, they talked trash to the newspaper, and then our coach said some tweet about U of D, and their coach talked weird back to him. So it was kind of like, I don't know. We had to win that.
Yeah.
You know, we talked trash to them at the end, and they didn't do what they about. So, you know, that's just who CC is.
Last time you guys played Mary's, it was a morning game, correct?
Yes.
And are you guys morning people? I mean,
no, not at all. No. I woke up and I was like, this might not be a good game. I was like, I had hope though, cause like I was thinking it was gonna be a crowd, and then once there was no crowd by the second half, I was just like, this is not.
What up, Nate?
What up, Lambo?
What up, Matt? Look back. Matt, where your head at? It's Matt Brick outside.
And we let the moment seize us. We gotta seize the moment. Carpe diem. Seize the day. And so that's what I want to see. Play with a lot of effort and a lot of confidence. The game plan is right. And the guys we got in the room is right. We just gotta come out with the mindset that we are not gonna bow here. So my final thing is this. Scripture I read today, Isaiah 54:4. Do not be afraid. You will not be embarrassed. Do not hold back. You will not come up short. Because we got nothing to lose, but we got a lot to gain. And you get a second chance to go slap somebody in the mouth who punked you the last time. And not many times in sports do you get a second chance, but you got one tonight. And I want us to just play with hearts on fire and playing balls to the wall for 32 minutes. If we do that, I think we're going to be good. Is that fair?
A 6'7" senior forward, number 4, Luke Solkowski. A 6'5" senior forward, number 13, Warren Marshall. A 6'8" sophomore forward, number 22, Trevor Smith. And a 6'2" junior guard, number 23, David Williams.
Yeah, Warren!
Defense! Defense! Defense!
Defense.
Rebound! Rebound! Yeah!
Their best against us, and I wanted to get thrown out, but I just knew how important 2 minutes. So I like, if I get thrown out, then I. So I just sat down, guys. That wasn't like I was quitting on you guys. I want you guys to know that.
Right, so we're right for 3, 1, 2, 3.
Right.
Right.
Yeah, we want to get
right. Right, play 3. Right.
Hey, come on, E.
In the day. Practice 25. Working on a CC offense.
Oh yeah, John.
Oh yeah, John.
First.
Yeah. Did I see you last night at the club? Think that was you. Shit. What's up? She think I'm famous.
We talked about playing Kellyanne twice. We gotta earn our way tonight. And it's just gotta be an elite focused effort. I love that type of energy from him. And I think when we are more loosey-goosey sometimes, that's not when we're at our best. When we are dialed in, it is eye to the tiger, strength like focus. And that's what we want to play. So I'm going to just challenge you guys. Same 3 things I said the other day. Championship culture, elite compete, and that we play with great character. If we do those 3 things, our culture is better than their culture. Our compete level has to be better than compete level. And character means it matters to us more than it matters to them. And that's going to be hard one tonight because it matters to them a lot. So we got to match that tonight. Not with we're going to go out there and throw blows with you. It's just, we're going to beat you X and O. Rebound. Get back on defense, defend the right way, take care of the basketball, low turnovers, put them in the basket. We're going to let our advantage of size beat them and not their spreadiness of shooting basketball. So I said it to you again, I'm going to say it every game until then. No one remembers personal records. They're always broken. Championships are never forgotten. They stay for forever. And that's what we're going after, championships. And you got a great opportunity to submit yourself to play for a championship. And it's 32 minutes of elite compete to get an opportunity to pay for something that's going to stay for forever. If that matters to you, it's going to matter enough to do the things we need to do to win. And make sense?
2 games, 32 minutes away from 2 games, 2 of our 3 games with Callahan on that we need. Yeah, let's go earn this one tonight.
Coach, this from last year, Luke, I started the season with this, but I felt led to share with you guys tonight. It's a scripture that says, when I was a child, I acted like a child, I spoke like a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things, right? And I think, like, all this season, we've had a lot of youth, we've had a lot of growth. Like, this is a stage, and this is the time where we gotta start being grown men. Put away the childish things, do what it takes to win. And I'm like, Ace, I'm looking at you right now. You were a kid in the beginning of the season, and the way you've been approaching practice, and you're growing up. Like, let's have a grown man game tonight.
Perfect man, Brother Rice.
Good shot, off again.
couple of things, man. You can't give one pass to kick down to that kid. Two, Warren shoots a pull-up, you don't get back, and they get a run out. Three, Lefty turns to his left. Like, what if you got stuck on that one? Let's just go under that guy. Right? Or yell, gap, gap, gap. But we can't let them do, like, those simple things that we got to eliminate.
His face.
His what?
His face.
His face?
They didn't feel like it yesterday, but you guys started kicking their ass and talking to them, and then they took it to a level that we need to go to. That's what we need every day. Because there's going to be days you don't have the energy to do it this time of year. Someone's got to give us one. Okay? Yeah, that's your best game for leadership. That's your best game. Who cares? We get to go to Callahan all night. We get to go to Callahan all night.
Stronger than nature.
Well, I think since we brought Coach Palmer to Brother Rice, I would have to say that, you know, people thought of, you know, the Warriors as a football school or a lacrosse school, and that guys came here were athletic. They played other sports that happened to play basketball. I think now the culture has changed to where we have guys that are coming to Brother Rice to play basketball.
I thought it was a really productive year. We talked about at this time last year, getting our culture all the way where we wanted it. For me, that was the primary goal. I told our seniors that, and I know we accomplished that for sure. We won a lot of games along the way. I loved how we stayed together. Practices were so great. Guys didn't point fingers. I really like this group. That's the worst part for me, not having them ultimately accomplish what they wanted to accomplish, but they still accomplished a lot, and I think we're set up to have success. Yeah, I mean, listen, we think we're, when I got this job, I thought if we could get where we consistently compete for Catholic League championships, it automatically puts you in the mix for state championships. When I said that when I first got the job, the league wasn't as good as it is now. I mean, that's for sure. If you're competing at a high level in the Catholic League, you're one of the five or six best teams in the state. So we think we've got the roster again to do that, for sure. Obviously, the defending champs now, they've got a lot coming back too. So it's going to be, I think they're like the target, obviously, everybody's target. But yeah, I think that's, as long as I'm here, I want that to be the goal. It's better to have expectations and fall short of them than when I got here when there was no expectations and exceed nothing. So we want to be a program that it's, you know, that's the ultimate goal. This team just re-energized me that, like, this is my passion and I love doing what I'm doing, but it's got to be done the right way. So, like, I don't know if anyone knows this, but I said going into this year, if this year wasn't enjoyable, I was done. So that just, even last year being 22-2, there were so many days that weren't that enjoyable when they should have been, that this year's group, again, even on a four-game losing streak, was enjoyable. So for me, having the right guys and doing things the right ways is what we're going to continue to do. I don't know if it's ever been done here, but we didn't lose a game at home this year. I know it hasn't been done my 6 years. For some years before that, they won many games. So I'm sure it's been a really long time, or maybe never been done where he didn't lose a game at home. I think Elijah's going to step up and take a big role from a leadership standpoint, but Dave as well. So I think you saw at the end of the year, you saw Dave has the mentality and the intangible stuff to lead. I think as he continues to become a better player, his personality, I think, is what you want in those big moments. So I'm excited to see the growth of all our guys, but I think those two will kind of take the reins.